and I haven't seen this one on YouTube yet, and I've got a few days free, so I thought I'd try it. Never done it this way, but I'd like to make a video and put it on YouTube, see if you would like it. What I'm doing, as you can tell by the title, is a stock removal tanto. A tanto is one of the samurai three blades. He originally carried the tanto, which is the small knife, the wakizashi, which is a small sword, and obviously the katana. So yeah, making one of these out of stock removal. So what I've done is I've cut the template. As you know, it's just a base template, it's not exact, but it's just from what I work from. I refine it more, obviously. I'll put a picture up here, and I've just cut the steel and grinded it down. If you want to see how I did that, you can watch how to make a dagger, and I'll show you grinding it all and stuff like that. So yeah, just got that ground down to bare metal, got that cut to size. So what I'm going to do is trace this template onto there, and then I'll get to grinding this out. So hope you all enjoy this video, and I hope you learned something. Alright guys, so quite like last time, when I just cut this, I'm just cutting this to 30mm at the moment. So pretty simple, straight down. Gonna take a little while because this is 5mm steel, but that's it, nothing too complicated to it. Just a straight fence so I can run my blade straight against, so it's all the same, even. Yep, that's it. Notice, yet again, people are gonna count me out if I don't talk about safety. So, safety here is, well, for me, I'm putting my gloves on first of all, because, well, it's very dangerous, isn't it? And all the sparks and everything like that, and you want to make sure they come up to your sleeves. Also, safety glasses, safety mask, guards, all that. I haven't got one, but my own risk. So, your guard, make sure it's properly positioned, because let's face it, you don't want to be cutting your fingers or cutting your wrists. So, with all that left aside said, I'm going to say it once throughout the video, let's carry on. So, all I'm doing now is I'm just removing this. Obviously I've cut it straight and I've grinded it straight now. So, don't need these on anymore. I've left it about 5 minutes just so it could cool down, so I'm not burning my hands. So, yep. Alright, so there's my piece of steel cut down to 30mm. Should be, let's have a look. 30mm, 30mm, and 30mm. Yep. Alright, so we're fine there. I'm just gonna try and get off a bit more of this scale and deburr some of these, but I'm just gonna do that on the belt sander. So yeah, again, simplicity at its finest. All I'm doing is drawing the template onto the steel mill. Let's look for a good corner. That's not too bad. So we'll draw the template onto the steel.
So there we go, nothing too difficult. So we got all them lines in there now. Just to cut that out.
So guys, all I'm going to do is begin now, is begin shaping the blade. So we got it all cut out, we got the template drawn on, all that good stuff. So all I'm going to do now is cut here close to as I can, and then get some of these bits cut out. So start shaping it and getting close to where the edges are. We'll be right back. just rewind it a second. Basically what that was is an angle grinder, kickback, throwback, whatever you want to call it. He come anything, you know, using less meat on a blade, wrong angle, anything really. It's very dangerous though, so this is why I added this. You want to be making sure you've got your protectors on, you want to be making sure you've got a good grip, you ought to be making sure you're safe. So use your protectors, have a good grip, always pay attention to what you're doing and make sure you stay safe while using your angle grinder. Alright, just wanted to put that out there again. So make sure you protect yourself and make sure you use it properly. Alright, back to the video. Guys, so what I have here is my belt grinder, also known as a belt sander with a load of boards piled up so it's 90 degrees and clamps keeping it in place so it's 90 degrees to the table. So with this, what I'm going to do is, as you saw, I remove most of the waste from the knife, so I'm just going to go up here, you know, grind this off, make sure it's true 90, give it that curve that it needs, get in here a bit, clean it up, and that's about it really. So here we go. So day two, not much is going on. I've just got to shape the blade. Yesterday got it all filed out, angle grinded, cut main and the bulk off. So today, just for me file and stuff like that, I'm just going to start shaping it. Get these corners 90 degrees, get all of it, get it all shaped properly. Basically what I'm doing here is I'm flattening this part out because this is for the habaki, and I'm putting a slight taper to this. So basically what's going to happen is when I do the suka, which is the handle, so basically how it goes first is the habaki, then the suba, and then the suka. So you want the taper for that. To put in the suka, because you customly carve that out. So I'm putting this flat part here for the habaki, then this taper, obviously how Japanese blades are done. So yeah, that's what I'm doing here.
So for some of you knife makers that are going to be wondering, why is he draw filing? Why don't he just use his belt sander or stuff like that? Well, personally, I'm too lazy to set up my belt sander. It's a lot of work, even though filing is as well. But I prefer filing them all straight. I prefer filing them all level. You know, you can use your belt grinder with your platen attachment. You can use your disc grinder. You can use anything you want. But personally, I prefer filing to get it all flat and even. So you are definitely going to want to be doing this if you're doing that. Your hard needs flattening and your edge needs flattening. All of it needs flattening and making square to each other. So, yep. That's why I file it all. So that's why I do that. Alright, this is quite an important part now. Got it mainly shaped and all that stuff. Now I want him to add in this part. Basically, this is the Hamachi. I think I'm pronouncing that right. And this is the Munachi. Basically, what these are for is the Habaki. It's for fitting the Habaki. These have got to be in line. These have got to be completely parallel to each other. This one down here, I've done roughly about an eighth of an inch, and this one up here just a little eighth of an inch, because I'm putting an eighth of an inch Habaki on there. So these need to be completely parallel to each other and small indents, and they need to run straight. They need to run straight for the Habaki, well, up to here anyway, or wherever you're putting your Habaki. So I've never seen this in a YouTube video, so I thought I'd add it that they do need to be straight for anyone who's confused about that. So yeah, get them straightened and then I'll show you when I've done that. So guys, as you can see now, my Hamachi and Munachi are completely parallel with each other. All of them have been squared completely to one another on all sides, on both angles. All my sides are now square, everything is square. So now it's to begin beveling. So make sure all this is square, make sure you've got everything completely straight, make sure you've deburred everything, and make sure everything's level for this next step. So hopefully I won't cock this up. Let's begin. Alright, so I've not really done much. All I've done is I have cleaned it, with white spirits, terps, use anything acetone or anything like that, just to clear all junk off it and stuff like that. So make sure you do this and we'll get on to the next step. Alright, so the next step is we're gonna draw the bevel lines on. So all that means is I'm gonna draw a line straight up here, draw a line straight down there, draw these lines in here and make sure all the bevel lines are on there to follow. So get that done. So I have got some problems with this, so I've had to put it on a table like this. It's going to be quite the struggle because I've got to take a 16th of an inch off each side here and go to a full blade with here, and I've got to go like this. So it's a bit of a struggle, but let's see what we can do. I hope I don't cock it up, so let's begin. I've roughed in the bevels with the angle grinder. Didn't go too far up because, you know, I couldn't really with the setup. So the rest of this now I'm going to do all by a file. So yeah, now I do it anyway. You could do it however you like, but I prefer doing my bevels with a file. So yep, I'll get to doing that and get these bevels put in. Definitely shouldn't have done it like I did. Not very smart with the wood drill bits and stuff like that because, well, exactly, very dangerous. It could grip at any time. But I've got it done, so there we go.
Hellcat.
Be a video if I didn't make some kind of mistake. What I did is I didn't get the scale off here well enough, so I've just had to go and file that all. And even though I've had to file off a bit more material, and I still need to do it, as you can tell, like there's still some scale here and stuff like that, but I took it off and I think it looks awesome. Where the lines where I'm filing up to, they've still got them here, and I think, well, even though they're not put in properly yet at this moment in time, but it looks absolutely really cool like that. Until we get the lines in properly and it'll be able to show and that'll look epic. But yeah, that looks cool as anything. Alright, so what I'm doing here, as you can tell by this ridge, it's not as clear here as it would be on than it is on the other side because I've just started working on this. But what I'm doing is I'm defining the Yokotic. I think I can't pronounce that very well, Yokotic. What I've done is obviously you have these bevels here that flatten, there we go, you can see it a bit better. That ridge there, that line. Traditional Japanese blades have them, nevertheless, well, most tantos. Yeah, all of them pretty much, well, yeah. And basically, how I've done that is, obviously, you file this way for these bevels, but you file at an angle like this, and you're flattening all this down to produce that Yokota. So this bit's actually thicker than this bit. Your tip's very thin. So yeah, that's what I'm doing here. That's what I've been doing, filing this Yokota. Show you at a different angle, see if that's any better.
So maybe as you can see here a bit better. There we go. That there is actually two different angles. This one is a lot thinner than that. So yeah. That's what the Yokotic is. Traditionally, this part's for stabbing, this is for slicing. So that's why it was done like that, two different edges. So yeah, carry on with this, and see you when I finally roughed in all the bevels.
Awesome. So you can see this from this edge, and this is what I was talking about. As you can see from here, it goes all the way down. It's very thin, this edge. To the point of where it is actually, I can still get this to come up. This edge at this moment should be anyway, but this actual bit here is here is 1.3 millimeters. In inches, that is 0.05 inches. So that edge is pretty damn tiny. Still a lot more work, so it will probably be thinner as well. But yeah, not going too bad at the moment. It's pretty cool. Yeah, awesome stuff.
All right, so truth time. Let's begin. All the bevels are in. All the bevels are defined. As you can see, the Yokote is defined. This bevel is defined. It's got this nice line now. These are completely flat. I've just brushed it up to 120 so you could see. Now all I've got to do is these tang ones and we'll be done. Alright, so truth. This started a lot more curved than these. The reason being for that is mild steel is not exactly very strong. By what I mean by that is when you keep filing it down and filing it down, this edge, as you can see here, like, it comes off, like, it will start coming thinner and snapping off. So that's what keeps happening. But just because this was stock removal and I've never done this, I practice, so yeah, but I'm quite happy with it. This Yokote, that is real, and it's all defined. I keep cutting myself on the blade while I'm polishing it, so yeah, it's not very nice, it's quite sharp. So yeah, these tang bevels need putting in now, and then we'll pretty much be done. Yeah, so I'll get that done. Alright, so a lot of you might be confused why I say tang bevels. But basically what that means is obviously you have your edge bevels here, and then you have, because it's no plunge line or anything like that, you have a bevel that comes down here. This, obviously, the Mune and the Hamachi obviously stop this from your plunge lines and all that stuff like that, spaces it. And this one you have, it's still got a flat here, it doesn't go as thin as there, so you'll take about 1 millimeter off, 1/16th of an inch off or so. I think I've took a little bit more than that because I've just been going a bit mad with file. But yeah, so you'll have these bevels basically at the top line here, matches up with your bevels here, and then you just go about 1/16th of an inch and 1 millimeter down and just keep beveling that. You don't want a plunge line or you don't want a cross line, you want it all to flow with one another. So yeah, just get this, you know, set your lines and just file away at it. So I'll put your 1/16th line or 1 millimeter line down there, file to that and file to this top line just like that. You want to make sure you have no tang line or bevel line or anything like that here. You want them all to flow with each other nicely.
Alright, so I've got all these bevels rough put in now, and yep, so they're all roughed in. All I'm going to do is give it a little polish, maybe up to 300 grit on both sides, and we'll be done. So I'll get back to you on that.
So I hope you've enjoyed this project, I hope you've heard, I hope you've learned a lot, and I hope you do it. If you have any questions or anything, leave them in the comments below, and if you feel like it, follow me on Instagram, Twitter, like me on Facebook, Metalworking page, and yeah, hope you've all enjoyed. Rate if you like, subscribe, and take it easy, hope you've all enjoyed it, thank you.